Hello YouTube. Welcome to another episode. And this episode, like I've been saying a couple times before, we're gonna go to the Nether, but I don't want to spend the whole time there since I know it's kind of boring for you guys, and well, anybody can go to the Nether on their own. So what we're gonna be doing this episode is we will be going to the Nether and exploring a bit. I've done most of the exploring, but we're almost out of glowstone, so I'm gonna quickly do a glowstone run in the Nether. And I've explored over 1,000 blocks in one direction, so pretty far. And what I'll do is I'll go to the Nether and fast forward you guys through everything I do over there, since we're just gonna be traveling in one long direction, getting glowstone, and on our way back. So I have all my stuff here, and I hope not to lose anything or die, because I would lose efficiency, fortune, and just about all my good tools. So yeah, I guess here we go. the glowstone, and we have a whole ton of glowstone. 5 stacks. Amazing. So yeah, I think that's all that I'm gonna be doing for now. I hope you like that speed run through that. And now I'll return to the village to do something else this episode. At least you didn't have to watch me do all that. That took like half an hour. So as you can see, we're really far, like 1,000 blocks from our portal. And I'm gonna have to run all the way back without getting lost. So, and not die, since I have all that very, very precious glowstone in my inventory. So that's what I'm gonna do now, and see you back at the village. Okay, hello, we're almost back at our village. Back all the way over here. It took me like 10 minutes to travel all that distance. These pigmen have to be really careful. They could push me off potentially into the lava, and I wouldn't be able to get out. So yeah, very dangerous. Don't like that. Probably have to make that wider, but I don't really plan to go there anymore since I haven't found anything. And there's lots of ghasts and whole bunch of other stuff that we don't want to have anything to do with. So I actually got a bit more glowstone, almost 6 stacks now, on the way back that I missed, and there's probably a few more places I missed too, but it doesn't matter. I think this is gonna be good enough. I just got what looked easy to get, and while this loads, here we are back at our little nether base with our nether warts and nether, well, I guess there's no nether bricks or nether fences here. But these still haven't grown, and I'm not sure why, because I haven't removed those for a long time. All the rest are pretty good. These ones haven't grown either. Mushrooms, I do not really want mushrooms. I guess I could use them for other stuff. Oh, I guess mushrooms can't have something right on top of them. I want to get rid of these mushrooms somewhere. Can't go on glass. Perfect. Okay, so let's go back now. Got a few gas tiers too. And quite a bit of netherrack. So, that was a good trip to the nether. Good trip. I'm happy about that. Okay, right now I'm thinking of stuff to do during this episode today. I'm not really clear on what I should do, or what you guys want me to do. I probably want to make something, I think. Let me get rid of all this stuff first. Oh, that's a nice amount of glowstone. And lots of arrows I used too. All those ghasts we met on the way. But I'll keep the arrows just in case. So, stuff to build, stuff to build, yes. Some of my friends said that I should build like a huge tower. And I did that in my old server. Not necessarily old, it's just that I stopped playing on it when I started making the LP videos. Because I wanted to start from the beginning so that you guys could see how I did everything. And that other server was also not legit. Like, a couple of times I went into creative to build something. So this is completely legit. Nothing's hacked. No XP is hacked. No items are hacked. Sometimes I might change the time from day to night if I wanted to do some creeper hunting or stuff like that. But I don't think that's really significant in terms of hacking. So, yeah. Probably gonna build a tower up to the limit, which is now doubled, 256 instead of 124. And I would just be like a huge skyscraper all the way up there. When I made it on the last server, it took like hundreds and hundreds of stone bricks. And a lot of ladders, a lot of wood, and it was only a 4x4 tower. So you can imagine how much that took me. It took me like at least 30 or 40 stacks of stone bricks. I made it out of stone bricks. I'll probably want to make it out of stone bricks. I think it looks nice as a tower. And like 4x4 is already huge, and it's just really resource consuming. So what I would do though is we'd probably start this. This would probably be a project that I'd show you guys, and maybe every day I'd complete a couple levels. So it might be right over here. So what I did on the last server, pretend these are stone bricks. I went like that, make a perfect 4x4. It's not necessarily 4x4 because the corners are cut off. So yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Each one of these layers took a quarter of a stack. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. No, wait, yeah, a quarter. 4 times 4, 16, a quarter of a stack. So 4 layers took 1 stack. And 256 minus, this is about level 60, I guess, is like less than 200. 200 divided by 4, that's like 50 stacks I've had to make of stone bricks. I mean, 50 stacks of stone, and like that's just really hard to get. So I'd probably keep with this shape because it looks sort of round, and it's an easy way to make it round, look round, without using too many bricks. Because if you wanted to make it perfectly round, you'd have to do something with like 3 and then 2 and 1 2 and then 3, and that would make it a lot larger, the circumference of this circle. So I'll probably pick the 4x4 again. It wouldn't necessarily be much to put stuff into, like make a hotel or something. That would just be too resource demanding, and I'm not willing to waste all that on something I'm not really going to use, aside from maybe going to the top and making like a diving board down somewhere. So yeah, why did I take this out? Just leave the template here. It will be 4x4, and what I did is have like here are ladders all the way up to two rows of ladders, which 200 levels, that's about 400 ladders divided by 3, I'd say that's about 100 times that. I'd say about 5 stacks of ladders to go up, I think. Just quickly calculating that. And then what I had was, just pretend this windows here, windows here, and windows here. The windows were made of iron bars because iron bars look phenomenally good and beautiful with the stone bricks. It just looks perfect for each other. So iron bars here, just two like that, and make it sort of like a battle tower. And it does take a huge amount of iron bars to make, but we have quite a bit from when we went to the stronghold. And then it would be a door on this side at the bottom. You enter here, it's a 4x4 space, and the floors, I'll probably make them out of wood. The floors are just like this. This is the floor, pretend that's the floor. And then these 2 blocks left down there are for the ladder, and these goes to lower levels and all the way up to level 256. And the floor is actually only 3x4 plus 2 spaces, which is not very big, but if you consider all the materials needed to make something twice as big, that would just probably take way too much stuff. I just don't have enough time for doing that. So, yeah, I'll probably make a first few levels just to show you guys how it's gonna be. And we have to pick an exact spot, and I think right here is the best spot because you can see it easily, and it will be really nice. Oh, one thing I also did on my other server, the one I stopped playing on, to make you guys this special LP, it had, it had, I'll just show you guys what it is since I still have the server. I'll quickly go on it and record, and I'll just show you guys what it's supposed to look like. I think this looks centered enough. I don't want it too close. Two blocks, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 blocks, and 2 blocks. So I can probably put an entrance here, sort of. Oh man, this is so complicated. I'll see what I'll do. So now I'll quickly show you guys what that server looks like. Hello and welcome to my original server, completely developed, just beautiful. I think it looks awesome. This is the best server I've ever made. It's also the first server I ever made. So yeah, it's been up for quite a long time, and I think that I am going to give you guys a world tour of this beautiful server sometime soon. Because I just think that it looks really nice and I want to show it off. And I've already made some videos of it because, like the hotel and the restaurant and a whole bunch of other stuff were all my old videos, which aren't LP videos of Minecraft, are all done on this server. So you guys might want to check that out. And when I do the world tour, I'm not going to go into detail in all those videos because each one of these things takes about half an hour or an hour to explain, and I'm not gonna explain it that much. So the world tour, I'll just quickly give you guys a brief run through of this server. And here's our tower. You can't see the top, it's still generating, and I think your render distance can't reach the top. So yep, this is it. Ouch. It's a very nice server, and this is the tower. These are just dispensers. Where did all the whoa, all my I had this full of fire charges. I didn't think it would get reset. Okay, so these are the floors. Iron bar windows, stone bricks, torches on either side, and wooden floor, and ladders that go all the way up to level 256. So quickly, well, not really quickly, sort of slowly, just gonna give you guys a quick view from here, all the way up. I'll just do that. It's really far and it takes a really long time to go up here with the ladders too, but I don't think there's much of a faster way to get up here. I know there's like water elevators, I mean like boat elevators or Minecraft elevators, but the thing is that SMP, they glitch through walls, and that's not gonna work because they'll just like move. If you like gently push them, they'll like move into a wall or stuff like that. I think we passed a cloud layer, because I don't see any clouds. It's not really cloudy today. It is in Vancouver here, though, in my real life. My window is all cloudy outside. It's a horrible day. Like it usually is, but that's Vancouver for you. So, oh, whoops. Here we are. This is, as you can see, a wrecked timer. See, all these are hacked. Like, this is level 46 enchantment. These swords can get you the best stuff at level 46. Except for sharpness 5. You never get sharpness 5 on one of these swords. Very rarely, but you get everything, like almost the best. Sharpness 4, fire aspect 2, knockback 2, looting 3. I have a ton of swords that are like that. Aw, come on, what's wrong with you? So this is my timer. I mean, well, clock. And what it does is it turns on this series of lamps, redstone lamps, on and off very nicely. And does that with almost no delay. And there's two layers of these, and then there's a window you can look around out from. And here is the top. Here we are at layer 255, and on these last blocks, 256. And you can see the absolutely whole huge world that's down there. That hotel looks more like a factory. A little igloo over there. I'll give you guys a tour of this world another time. It's going to take a couple of hours, I think, to go through all the stuff that's here. So 256. Up here you can't place blocks. Like, above this level. I'm right clicking. You can't place blocks above that. But you can place torches above level 256. Along with water and lava and other non-solid blocks, I think. So yeah, all my friends, Dexter, Scapegoat, Skyline, and one of my other friends, Carlin, I think he expected to be on my other server. Okay, so yeah, this is the tower, level 256, and yeah, so there's ladders all the way down, and I want to make something like this, but probably bigger. I think I might put the lamps around the outside of the tower, and then have the redstone on top of it, so that it blinks like this. It looks like a lighthouse, and so yeah, I think that's gonna look pretty cool. And that's gonna take quite a few episodes to do, actually. So yeah, also everything's done on this server, like everything's built. You see that thing over there? That's a lava and water house. You can check my video out, whenever you want. There's, I think, 3 videos I've made so far on this server of specific things. Number 4. Number 1, my hotel. Number 2, a giant underground farm for food. Any type of food, basically, almost. A lava and water house. A lava roof, and the walls are made of water. A restaurant. And a giant mine shaft that I made underground. And I think that's it. I don't remember anything else. And it's turning nighttime now, so look at that sunset. That's really bright. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go down and give you guys a look from what the glowstone looks like from down there. So let's head down. Where should we? Okay. And there you go. You can see the lights going on and off up there. Very faintly, though. It's not really noticeable. Let's see if it gets a bit darker. And I'll get a better view up here, maybe. And the tree's blocking it. Let's see. I need to be able to take a good look at this so you guys can see what I'm going to try to build. And this is what takes so much effort and resources. So you can see one side of it's going off a bit sooner than the other, because I had to add a repeater in there because the redstone signal didn't reach. And I'll probably fix that when I do it on my other server. So it's blinking on, off, on, off, on, off, on, off. So yeah, that's what I'm gonna build. And yeah, I guess that's gonna be it for now. And see you guys back on the other server. Hello YouTube, and we're back on my server again. So yeah, I think this is gonna be the end over here, and I have something planned next episode. We're building a minecart track to his house together. We're gonna make it under the desert and over the jungle. So that's something to do next episode. And I'm gonna just end this here. We're gonna build the tower in another episode, when I remember to. So I won't do that now because we don't have time for that now. And yeah, look forward to next episode. Okay, quickly, I forgot. I wanted to add here. We have all the music discs. Oh, not that one, 'cause you can't. So, music disc 11 is not obtainable in survival. You can only get it through creative. Well, for now it is. So we have 13, we have can, we have blocks, and we have chirp. We have far, we have mall, we have Elohi, we have strad, we have ward, and the only one we don't have is stall, which is the black music disc. And I'll probably keep trying to kill more creepers, see if we can get one. And we have more than two of every, at least two of every music disc except for our strad. So we only have one over here. So yeah, I'll see if I get stall, and then another episode I'll give you guys a listen to every music disc, although you've probably heard it like a million times. So yeah, that will be nice. So it'll be a music listening episode. Well, I'll probably just give you guys a listen to every song, every whole song. And that will probably take the whole episode, so it might get boring because I'll just stand here and listen to music, but you guys don't have to be here. Nice music. See you guys next episode.